si myslím, že propaganda je očividná, že záleží i na každém autorovi. Každý má nějaký svůj subjektivní názor a i když chce nebo nechce ho ukázat, tak vždycky se nějak v těch textech nebo v nějakých těch vyjádřeních vlastně projeví.
Já se s tím setkávám, řekla bych, všude, protože média v dnešní době usilují jenom o to, aby se jim zvedla čtenost, sledovanost. A používají k tomu nejčastěji titulky, které jsou postavené takovým tím hraničním způsobem. Něco, co lidi okamžitě zaujme a upoutá. A aby si ten článek přečetl.
Určitě se bála moje rodina, nechtěli mě tam pustit, ale já jsem samozřejmě řekla, že to je moje věc, jestli tam pojedu nebo ne.
Na začátku jsme se jí báli hodně, hlavně v tom Rakousku, protože to byla první zkušenost vlastně s natáčením mezi nimi a my jsme pořád čekali nějaký útok.
Že nám ti uprchlíci můžou něco udělat, protože ta televize vykresluje jako zvířata, ale ve skutečnosti to tak vůbec nebylo. A já jsem potom rodině ukázala všechny ty záběry a snažila jsem se jim to vyvrátit, že opravdu to tak není.
Připravíme, vystřídejte se a jdeme.
Myslím si, že je hodně důležitý přemýšlet o tom, jakou sílu mají informace a čím může být motivovaný ten zdroj toho sdělení, protože mediálním světem se šíří spousta lží a polopravd. A příkladem toho je třeba moje ségra, protože ta, když byla v první, druhé třídě, měla nejlepší kamarádku a ta byla muslimka. A ségra tehdy rozdíly mezi nima vůbec nevnímala, byly jako prostě sestry. No a když jsme se vraceli z našeho natáčení na Lesbu, tak zrovna došlo k teroristickým útokům v Paříži. A od mojí ségry mi tehdy přišla SMSka, ve které se mě ptala, proč si myslím, že bychom měli uprchlíkům pomáhat, když jim ve škole říkali, že jsou to všechno teroristi?
Můj názor na teroristické útoky je takový, že každý člověk je jiný a ty útoky tady byly před uprchlickou krizí v roce 2001. Budou tady po uprchlické krizi.
Vidět to všechno na vlastní oči, to se vůbec nedá srovnávat s tím, když to vidíte zprostředkovaně z televize. Působí na vás moc ty emoce, všechno to dění vysílá takovou zvláštní energii, že vás to prostě mění. Hýbe to jakoby s tím, jak prožíváte ten každý den. A pro mě bylo asi nejtěžší to, že jsem cítila strašnou bezmoc. Já jsem prostě těm lidem chtěla pomoct, chtěla jsem to nějak vyřešit, ale nebylo jak.
My jsme nevěděli, jak se máme chovat. Já jsem se bránila tomu pohledu tím, že jsem se na ten svět dívala skrz kameru. Snažila jsem se ho vidět úplně jinak, neviděla jsem ho jako realitu. Všechno, co se nám stalo, mi vlastně došlo až po tom, co jsme se vrátili.
People, they are changed within the war.
They want a better life. They want to save their family, okay? And they make it right. But we are not ready to come so many people.
Our aim to work for me and for my children to continue their study in base and without complication.
I don't like them. I don't go to see them, you know? I don't like. Is it my personal opinion, you know?
Go to Germany and still in the Stuttgart or Berlin for continue my studying and life saved.
So Islam is a way of life. And in a way of life, there's nothing to worry about.
No, it's okay. For me it's okay, but you know, it's not nice, you know, if you see every day, every morning, you know, in the streets.
We don't like to move in illegal way. We want to be legal.
The political system, it is for laughing. First thing, they lie to all Europe.
No picture, video.
You must talk with her.
Oh my God. Do you marry me?
Yeah. Oh, I don't know. Maybe it will be better to know you more.
It's okay.
But if you arrive to Czech Republic, it will be.
More in the back,
started this whole project 5 weeks ago. At first we were just a few people with water and some food in the car and a few tables.
All by me. Every person.
Five weeks later, we now have about 3,000 people registered who are helping us. We have a little hospital, we have some corporations with companies, we have a little kindergarten, we have basically everything what the people need. There are about 800 people, like nurses and doctors, who are organizing themselves in a Facebook group. We can take a little look in there. Everything is donated. We got, for example, an ultrasonic machine to watch for pregnant women. We nearly got a baby was nearly born. I can show you that. There is the picture of the little girl.
One for you.
Yeah, yeah, really.
We have also a psychological care. They are watching mainly on us because there are people here working 24 hours and don't want to go home. Like we need to tell them, okay, people, get home, get to sleep. We had people here who didn't went into school because they wanted to work here. They get problems with the school, so they take care about us. They try to keep us healthy, they try to send us home when it's time to go home. They try to help us if there are like problems in between ourselves. It's like we're in a special situation, and there are sometimes we fight and we don't know how to talk to each other because we are stressed and we don't get sleep, and they help us a lot.
Yes. Wow, schau mal. Nehmen seine Majaska. Schauen Sie, Sie dürfen nur ein Video machen, wenn Sie eine Chili nehmen. Majaska. Nehmen Sie.
Yeah, I'm Lucas. I'm Lucas Kurtz. I'm 20 years old. I finished school, and I'm currently waiting for my civil service in Austria. And yeah, that's actually all about me to know. I'm currently here because my grandfather was a refugee from Hungary, and I actually know how it's like to grow up in a city where you actually a foreign people, you don't belong here. And when I heard in the news at Hauptbahnhof there's a camp building up, they need people to help, I actually said, okay, I got the time, I'm unemployed.
It's amazing, they always take also for the little siblings. So they come here, bring it to the siblings and come back and bring them more. They're really, really social.
I grew up in Scotland, then I came to Hungary when I was 8 years old, and when my mother married an Austrian man, I actually came to Austria when I was 9 years old, and my grandfather already lived here because he fled from the civil war in Hungary in the 1965, and so I actually had family here. And mainly my story is actually, or my journey, my daily journey is I actually live here. So I'm actually sleeping in one of our storage tents, or I'm sleeping at a friend's place, or I'm sleeping at my girlfriend's place, and mainly the whole time I'm here. The most useful for them is actually to give them the feeling that they're safe in the country. Finally, that they're welcome here. Even that we got the right-wing party, which is growing stronger and stronger every day, but we have daily about 300 to 400 people which are helping, and that's actually the best thing we can do.
This is our Dolmetscher crew. We have lots of people like Muslim Jews, or some, they are dolmetsching for us in every language possible.
Advisor.
It's a really good thing because when the refugees come out.
Hamawa. Friend Hamawa. Captain Hisham Hamawa.
Hamawa.
Captain Hisham Hamawa. Hello.
Hello, my name is Dana. I am coming from Syria because of the war, first of all, and because of our situation and relatives in the country. People, they are changed within the war. Nobody help you, even your family. I stay at home to grow up my children. My husband, he is working in pharmacies.
The most difficult stage of this journey, it was when we passed the sea, when we crossed the sea from Turkey to Greece. And especially, we have daughters, and the smallest one, she is 3 months. So we are suffering, we can't explain.
There is a group of people on Facebook where they organize the people who are here, who can take care of the children. We're playing with them, we're taking care, they draw a lot of things. amazing pictures sometimes. We have, sometimes they write, oh, thank you, Austria, and something, and it's great to see. There are also bad things to see, for example, if they draw their home and they draw the bombs who are dropped on their homes. And it can also be very, very, very sad if you see so. These kids are with their families, but sometimes we get these people like a 16 years old without their parents. They are just here. They don't know what to do, where to go. They are alone. They have no friends, and that can really, really be a big problem also for us. We got lots of families were torn apart at the borders or at many different occasions. We take the names of the families who or of the people who get lost. We print photos. We try to connect to other organizations like Red Cross or something. And we also found a lot of people actually. We have our found map. It's pretty amazing. These are all people we found. We're very happy about that.
My name is Fajdi, I'm from Afghanistan. I came to Iran, from Iran to Turkey, then we came to Bulgaria. And even I cannot count how many mountains we walked by pedal, like maybe more than 60 mountains or maybe 70 mountains. And I lost my small brother in Bulgarian mountain. Suddenly the police came, holding the gun and dogs in their hands and searching you guys to shoot you, to catch you by dogs. And everyone runs away and I couldn't find him.
How old is he?
17.
إن كنت يا قلب ما تقدر على
I say, go back. Why?
You can't
go there, you know, between them.
Over the fence.
Why? Because it must be order here.
Why?
Because of the order.
Okay. That's okay.
They have just they have water there.
Okay, give us the argument.
First aid.
Yes, just one, there was just no water.
Jeff, please. They have water. They have water.
Talk first.
They have water.
Okay.
They have first aid. They have first aid. Yes.
Would you shut up for a while?
Okay.
My God.
Food will get in Dobova or in Brezhnev food.
Yeah, in 2 days.
I'm sorry.
Problem with the police here. They closed the way. Nobody can help, just them. And from them, here nobody. We are trying to give him some water, some anything, but yesterday they have a small problem in the another camp. One of the Syrian guys, he was 30, they don't give him water for all. It was very hot in that camp. It was closed, and he took some fire and he was trying to kill himself.
Every day, every night.
They come in all day?
Yes, all days, all night.
And how long?
It is a few days, but Croatia police work nothing.
Why?
In the night, train coming without lights. The people go through the river, and Croatia police, that's it. Go there. There is bridge, but no. Please say go there.
Yeah, Hungary is close.
Close?
Yeah. Serbia is not Europe.
And Croatia.
No, just go. Just corridor. We make registration for all these people. One, Europe, and many rules.
So,
situation started in the end of April here in Lesbos, especially, and it was a lot of refugees, but tourists saw them every day here in the streets, in schools, in squares, everywhere. And for tourists, that's not a good picture. If you go somewhere for holidays and you see this picture, it's not good. That's why a lot of companies cancelled people and tourists to come here, Lesbos. If this condition going like this every day, people from Turkey come there, from Syria, these refugees, it would be a big problem from our island, from the tourists, because it's one part to live from them, from tourists.
شما دوست دارین آقا اینجوری مثلا چه بگم خود سوریه عراقی نگو موبازن اینا مسلمان هم دیگه هر کی عقیده ای داره یکی دوست داره موباز باشه دوست داره روسری مثلا خانم ما معلوم روسری بزنه حالا منم رفتم با روسری میخواد
دوست کنم Change our life for what? Because we wake in the morning and you see all the women with madiles, how you call it, you know, ferenjé. We see women on the road, you know, different. We see many black people, you know, faces, you know, especially the Afghanistan, people from Asia. They are the most dangerous people and they make big troubles in the city because always they fight with the Syrians. Of course, we are very happy because all the volunteers here from the Europe to help us because now you see it's clean, the road is clean. Why? Because come the volunteers and they help. We are lucky because come from the Europe to help us. Because without them, we'll be house completely. Let's go. The Turkish now, they want to make money from the refugees. They want to steal them. They try to steal. With the Turkish, the port police, they make the same work. We see many videos in the TV.
They attached their boat.
That is the boat, yes. And we see many videos in the TV. They use the boats to make, you know, they use the boats to make waves. You know, one boat, if you are in the plastic, small boat, and you go slow, and pass one big boat next to you with a fast, they make big waves. So this way, with this way, the boat turn. The waves go like this, very high, and turn. So they send the people to die. They don't mind. They mind only to get the money. When they get the money, it's all right, that's it. They don't care after that.
Turkish border, he follow us. He follow us and they around us.
خیلی نامبشون خیلی نامردن خیلی
نامردن you follow us, we running from him and you stop yes, it was horrible, it was so bad.
You
stop us and tell us give him money and we tell him we don't have any money.
Police?
Yes, police tell us give him money.
Give you money?
Yes.
And
what?
If you said that I have no money, yes. what did they do?
And with a ship hit our boat. We almost drop, you want to drop our in water.
And how many people were on the boat?
50 people.
50 people?
50 people in 10 minutes, 10 meters.
Oh
boat.
My God. It's for 10 people, I think.
It was so
it's
bad.
Very dangerous.
Yes, very dangerous. But we don't have anything for to do. We must.
Jednou večer jsme vyrazili na plavbu kolem pobřeží a narazili jsme na člun plný uprchlíků, který byl přeložený, takže praskl a potápěl se. Posádka člunu ztratila směr, protože byla tma a oni si mysleli, že když se budou orientovat podle odlesků ze záchranných vest, které se povalují na pobřeží, dostanou se bezpečně až k pláži. Jenomže nejvíc vest zůstává v místech, kam se nedá dostat a uklidit je, takže buď ve skalnatých oblastech nebo v místech, kam nevede silnice. Kvůli skalám se nemohli dostat až k pláži a museli kousek doplavat. Problém ale byl, že na lodi měli i malé děti. Všude byla panika a zmatek a jeden Iráčan mi podal svého syna a já, když jsem se nahýbala přes okraj našeho člunu, měla jsem neuvěřitelný strach, aby mi nespadl, protože on na sobě neměl ani záchrannou vestu. Náš kapitán se bál do lodi vzít i jeho otce a z toho místa jsme museli navíc odplout pro pomoc, protože ti lidé tam zůstali uvězněni. Já jsem měla to dítě na rukách celou noc a nevěděla jsem, kam s ním jít, co mám dělat, nebylo to komu říct, protože na tom pobřeží žádné úřady prostě nefungují.
Call somebody maybe. Call somebody with your... Maybe pull them.
Yeah, yeah. Can you translate?
It's possible.
Yeah,
okay, hold it.
Just children, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, but
father.
No.
Don't take it.
Ten chlapec se jmenoval Navas. Poznala jsem to, protože měl na ruce stříbrný náramek se jménem a bylo mu 9 měsíců. Já teď opravdu moc děkuju americkým pediatrům, kteří na pobřeží provozovali něco jako mobilní ordinaci, dali mi pro něj suché oblečení, jídlo a potom s námi jezdili několik hodin po ostrově a snažili se najít jeho rodiče. Nevěděli jsme vůbec, jestli se nám to podaří, protože já jsem jeho tátu viděla pouze na několik vteřin a nikdo netušil, kam ti lidé půjdou.
Bebek.
leave it. Leave the boat. Come inside.
Water.
He's got water on board, he says. They have water on board.
Do you have anything for baby? Okay, where's the mother with the baby? Where's the mother with the baby?
Okay.
Not the bags. Okay.
No, no, no. No. Bring her over.
Perfect. She's so beautiful.
Perfect,
she's so beautiful.
She's
so beautiful.
My name is Ina. I'm from Norway. I'm working in the Child Protective Service in Norway. And I'm here as a volunteer with Lighthouse. We just had a boat arriving here in the shoreline. Young boys, men primarily, from Afghanistan.
And how many boats arrive during the day to this place?
It depends. Up to a 90. But that's then it's a hard day. It's a really hard day.
Afghanistan.
Potom, co jsme se vrátili z natáčení, mi všechno přišlo jako strašné kraviny, co lidi řeší. Když jsme viděli lidi, co nemají domov, co putují za tím, aby nějaký získali, vedou svoje děti, jdou těhotné ženy, kterým hrozí to, že vlastně zemřou nebo jejich dítě zemře, a my tady řešíme úplný malichernosti.
Tak já, kdybych byla uprchlík, tak utíkám tam, kde se budu mít líp. A půjdu do státu, který nabízí takové sociální jistoty, které mi zajistí bezpečný a pohodlný život jak pro sebe samou, tak prostě pro moji rodinu.
Kim gelipti hoşuma, ne iş gelip başıma, yaş dola dola gödlere, tanışmışam gödlere, hop düzinle çahanlar, bir göl göldü göllerim, yadan çıktı sözlerim, bu kız aman bir aman, çok meni sevilip tamam, dedim çatar küme güme, teselli bir üre güme, keçti meni de apardı, zengi geldi telefonum, tuşumdu cananımdı, hemen güzel hanımdı, desteği tez götürdüm, birden uzunu itirdim, canun canun sesiydi, onun refikasiydi, geldim hele bir meğam, hey işte her şey tanım, bir zaman akşam çalır, uregime çektim dalı, ah neydi alacım, var idi ihtiyacım, heyli helal dolaştım, ahırda razılaştım, bu dostluk mehribanlık, beni değişti giranlık, somlaran hayatımı, yandı ehvalatımı, danıştım o canana, o da danıştı yana yana, dedim sevgi muhabbet, vermeyip mene züllet, sevilme bilmedim ben, ama vakti çağırıyam, senden de bir çağırıyam, soruştum derdin nedir, bu cür cevap söyledi, an veririm ben sana, boysa hürmetim bana, menne hiç soruşma, cahalu hatta danışma.